discounts the fact that the two initial terrorists in San Diego rented rooms in the home of another Saudi who happened to be an FBI informant. So the FBI in San Diego literally was sitting on the two lead hijackers. There's all kinds of embarrassing things in there. But all of that material could probably be summarized and written up in some detail in maybe 5 or 10 pages. There are clearly a lot of other things in that chapter, because when Congressman Massey said, "This changed my thinking about everything that has gone on for the past dozen years," he wasn't kidding. In private conversations, Congressman Jones has said very similar things. It raises profound implications about our government and the way we deal with certain countries that are treated as allies but should never be treated as allies. So it's the McCarthyite climate of terrorism and fear that is what's going on here, not the specific punishment. Because in a certain sense, winning this fight for the 28 pages is really a fight for the soul of this country. It really comes down to that. It's not the only fight for the soul of this country, but it is a very important fight, and we're within striking distance of winning. So that's, I think, a little bit more on where this fight stands and what Congressman Jones and others mean when they say that they feel that there's a tremendous threat. People have died under mysterious circumstances in order to silence them from the kind of truth that they know if they're willing to fight for it. So this is a real life and death battle that we're dealing with here, and it's not a matter of just the historical record or even our ability to fight more effectively against ISIS down the road. This is all about the soul of the United States, which has been basically destroyed and has to be recaptured again.
We'll take more questions. So whoever has questions, or whoever, who is it? Oh, well, whoever it is has to go to the central microphone. You can take two? Okay, right, go ahead.
My name is Hideki, Syrian American. I'm here, I have 3 questions and 1 more. The first question, when Mrs. Clinton, she said, "We fund Al-Qaeda." Then they fund Al-Qaeda, and they support it with the money, with the guns, with everything. And in the end, they come to give us the death of our kids here and our family here. The second thing, what Obama doing now, he said he fighting ISIS in Syria when 200,000 people killed and more than 30 women raped. And our kids' organs, cells, they sell it in Turkey. The problem now, we have the government, our president, Mr. Assad, we elected, he's legit, and our army.